Hi, this is Baptiste, CEO at Crisp. Today, we'll do a video tutorial to set up your first trigger on Crisp. So let's get started. So on Crisp, we have to go to the plugin tab. And finally, we have to go to triggers. We have to create our first trigger using the black button. We have to name our first trigger. For instance, we can name it Growth Hack. And we have to set the trigger identifier, which can be useful if you want to fire your trigger later using JavaScript. You can name it like you want. So we will name it Growth Hack as well. So here is the interesting part in triggers. Now you have to set an action. So we have three kinds of actions. You can show a message, open the chat, or play a sound. What I suggest is to show a message. We can target our message depending on the user language. So we set it by default, but you can also select your language, target a language in the list. So you can now write whatever you want. So my first trigger. And note also that Crisp supports Markdown. So you can create bold text and many other really cool stuff using Markdown. I'll add the Markdown link in the description. So we'll create a bold text. So this is a bold text. So my first message is now created. And now we have to set this trigger on specific pages. So what I want is to set on a specific page. But it's also possible to fire a trigger on other behaviors. So onLive intent is basically to fire the trigger when the user tends to close your website and to switch to another website. So Crisp is having an algorithm detecting such patterns and then sending the right message. You can also send your trigger when clicking on a custom checkout button, for instance. So you'll have then to use the click on event, click on link. And for developers, developers can use user event and user data features. So we use, on our side, on pages. So we'll create our first trigger on a blog. The Crisp blog, crisp.chat/blog. And now you can target your message on all the subpage of the directory, so all the page under the blog section. And you can also target on all the subdirectories. So you'll have to match using two wildcards. So using two wildcards will match all the sub pages. And now we can add a delay. So for instance, we can send our message after 3 seconds on the website. And to prevent to send the trigger if we are not online, to prevent from having angry visitors, we can basically enable execute only if website online. So if we have at least one agent online, visitors will be able to get our automated messages. So it's saved. Now we can enable the trigger. And let's start on Crisp. So we go to our blog section, crisp.chat/blog. And we try on any blog article. So the chat is there. We have to wait 3 seconds. And here is our message. My first trigger. And of course, we have the bold text. Thank you for watching. And don't hesitate to watch our other videos about the other plugins. Thank you.